It's not still a seed application for us. So you see the market difference between the two. So the lesson here is when faced with a dead end in your spiritual journey, do you blame God? Or if you stand still and wait to see what God will do, do you still trust God? This is easier said than done. How do you trust God? It's so easy to say, oh, just trust God. No, but it's not that easy. Let me give you an illustration. Trusting God is not easy. It's like cliff jumping. Let me try this. That's something I'm going to do. Have you tried cliff jumping? You know, jumping off a rock into water. Okay. That's it. You know, I've done this. I don't remember when, but I was 4 feet then. No, I'm trusting God is like a cliff jumping. First time you do it, you are not sure if you can make it, you know. What if there, whatever may do, but you can't see, right? What if you reach, some of my friends say, what if you reach the bottom, okay? And you might get, injured, you know, your legs. What if you fall on your belly? And if you jump and fall on your belly? I don't know. So many questions. There's this one solution. How do you solve the solution of the worry? You just jump back. The solution is to simply jump. Okay? So, the first time I did this, I jumped from a waterfall. I didn't like to do it, but I was, all my friends had already jumped. I wasn't even thinking about the land of the past. So that's why I jumped, okay? When I did, it was so much fun that I climbed back. Immediately I climbed up the rock, and then jumped again, and then jumped again. Okay? Why did I do that? I felt it was safe, learned it was safe. So, the rest of there is trusting God is just like that. Okay? It's only the first time that it's hard. So after you have tested God, after you have tried Him, you'll find His faithfulness is overwhelming. Okay? And that you'll be ashamed of all the time that you cannot trust Him. Why? Psalms 34:8. Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is a man that trusts Him. So, the Bible is what? This baby is inviting us to trust God. It said, taste and see. Parang tumitikim na, nagpo-promote na pastillas sa bus. And then the pressure to buy that. The author of Psalms is someone who has known God all his life. David must have known God so much that God has actually endorsed him, saying, this man, David, is a man of the man of heart. And it's actually very simple, but this guy knows me all well. He doesn't kill an animal. Actually the Psalms were a collection of clues on how God related to David. And it's a good read. If you go to Psalms, you'll find there how a person can relate to God in different ways than most of us do. So let's just read Psalms all year to that. So, how do we know? What's the proof that God, that David trusted God? When he was going to fight the king, so that he didn't pull out. You know, And itong kalaban mo, he has been a soldier, he's old, he's big, and he's been a soldier all his life. But what did David say? He said, when a bear comes to me and a lion comes to me, I fight against him. And God has always protected me and has always given me victory. Now, look at him. Was that a lucky shot? No? Si David, when he fought with Goliath, he was not some brother. He had experience, and he was banking on that experience of being